Careful with the weapons of the guards, Watcher. They seldom come without strings. Who are these guys?
I've heard enough.
Darien? The sounds of an argument reach you from the stairs. Darien marches into the room, arms crossed, while Wengra bounds along behind him.
This threatens all of us now.
Oh, the ogre's right. Matron Berrigan lumbers after Darien and Wengra, flanked by two stout ogres. Well, surely you mean to help us. You're not going to attack us now, right?
She's right. We've got to fight together.
Oh, Darek. You also recognize a Darek following them. His shoulders are rigid and his arms are clasped in front of him. Wengra sees you and points enthusiastically.
See, Darien, she'll tell ya. We can stop him.
Tension crackles in the air. Darien whirls and cuts Wengra off with a chopping motion.
If she's seen them, she knows better.
What's going on here?
Something killed a whole crew of hunters out in the wood. Tore them apart like dolls. Insects.
Despite his steady posture, his eyes flit and flicker like flies, and his upper lip shines with sweat. This is a very sweaty place, isn't it?
Something like the creatures that attacked my fort, perhaps?
Berrigan mutters something to her escort, and they snort in agitation.
I told ya! All we gotta do is get him in range of these cannons, and then we blast them!
She brings her hands together in a loud clap.
We don't even know what they are!
He shuts his eyes and breathes loudly through his nose. I do. Everyone turns to look at you. They're known as the Eyeless.
The destruction my dreams warned me of.
Berrigan's gaze is distant with horror. Suddenly she rounds on Wengra and Darien.
And your greed and recklessness have brought them on us all!
Oh god, don't fight, guys. She rolls her shoulders back and bares her teeth at the two villagers. Rage hangs around her like a musk. Darien and Wengra each take a step back and square off against the ogres.
You burning our village didn't help matters none.
Wengra's feral grimace exposes needle-sharp teeth. She has needle-sharp teeth?
It wasn't my clan that attacked you!
Berrigan's nostrils flare.
No difference. One ogre stinks as bad as the next.
Not good, not good, guys. Calm down. Berrigan's right. You wanted something you didn't understand. Your interests have never aligned with Stalwart's, Berrigan. I feel like this is too passive, and this is too aggressive. And I don't want to piss off Berrigan, which is 1, 2, 3. I don't want to tell her to go, because we could use their help. Enough. You're all idiots, arguing over ancient history at a time like this. Darien and Wengra grumble, shifting on their feet and glaring sullenly. After a pause, Berrigan looks back at you.
I came to offer my clan's help.
She folds her hands. The others gawk at her.
The White March has been our home for centuries. We'll defend it alongside you.
The ogres flanking her grunt their assent. Your aid would be welcome. She presents an ancient banded horn in both of her calloused hands, holding it out to you.
Sound it anywhere in the White March, and three of my best warriors will be at your side. Your battles become ours.
She bows. Awesome. I love the way they walk.
What's your plan for dealing with them exactly?
The eyeless are hidden at Karen's Scar. I'll face them there. Wengra and Darien gape at each other in disbelief.
That lake's notorious! Folk never come back from that...
She breaks off, her eyes suddenly wide.
Oh!
You'll need all the help you can get. I have fewer men to offer than I would like, but the Iron Flail stands ready. Our siege weapons are at your disposal.
Oh. It's good to know I didn't kill them all off.
The same ones you threw at the battery's walls?
Darien bristles. We're coming together. Am I going to have to intervene again?
These Eyeless will come for us all if they aren't stopped here and now.
And Derek doesn't even look at him.
Forget it. You're not bringing your army into our backyard.
Darien's face flushes. He looks to you and nods.
Tell him.
Badass answer. Adaric's right. We need to work together. It's no time to worry about what's past, Darien.
Guess you're right. Won't be anything left of Stalwart if we don't stop these monsters anyway.
That's right. He looks down at the spot. His heel has ground into the grit. Adaric says we'll assemble at Karen's Scar and await your orders. Be ready, my friend. It will be a great battle. Adaric bows slightly and steps away. Very, very interesting. An awkward silence follows. Wengra clears her throat noisily.
You know those heavy cannons you fixed might come in handy.
She grins, a mischievous twinkle in her eye. Darien starts to groan, and she holds up both hands.
Hear me out. Karen's Scar should be just in range for those guns. You just point out your target, and I'll do the rest.
If those things are on the move, we don't have much time.
Right.
If you're really gonna stop them, take this. It's the best of the ore we've pulled from Stalwart's mines.
He gives you a solemn nod.
It's not much. But it's good enough to make the old Pargrunan Smiths proud. I'm sorry about what I said before. Just don't take it out on the rest of the village.
He looks away. Loving this. You may call upon the aid of Crag Ogres by using Berrigan's Battlehorn and Karen's Scar. You can call for the Red Saren's aid by using the Burning Pitch Trebuchet ability in Karen's Scar. Okay, and I was granted that. You may call upon the cannons of Durgan's Baronry by using the Heavy Cannon Blast ability in Karen's Scar. And I was granted that. Never seen anything like it. I had better hammer like that, could Craig track it. Crack a dragon's skull in one blow. What? They say you cleared the West Tower. Yeah. Very, very cool. Let's go to the Great Hall. This puts us... Oh yeah, I wanted to go outside. Yeah, I need to go back to get more... what do you call it? Camp supplies. Wish I could have seen you deal with those monsters. The battery still holds many riches. Indeed. Anyone around here? Lodgar? Is Wengra hanging out around here? Apparently not. So, I gotta head back and get camping supplies. I really just want to take a peek at the map at this time. I wonder if anyone in Stalwart would have anything new to say. Karen Scar, right here. Okay. I don't know if people say anything different. The crew at Durgan's battery said you got those cannons working. Thanks. They say the eyeless caused the recent avalanches. Did I always have this? I don't remember this. Okay, well, in any case, what they gave us... Is that this baby sitting in our... backpack. I'm sure we took care of him already. There it is, Barragan's battle horn. One per rest. Summons three Crag rogues. Matron Barragan gave you this battle horn to summon her ogres to fight the eyeless at Cairn Scar. Dented metal bands encircle the battle horn, and a tattered gold ribbon hangs from the middle. First ogres, then red sarens, now this? I keep thinking we're due for a real break. I'm not turning around.
Back to warm your hands, eh? What can I do for you? Nothing like a pint.
Nothing like a pint. Only one? Look at all this stuff. Looking faster. This is insane. 67,000 so far. $75,000. And hold on to some of this stuff, I don't know. $80,000. All the prayer bracelets. One of these prayer books. One of these pangram books. Animat. Love that crap, huh? All these animals. Baby Lagafath. Okay.
Back to warm your hands, eh? Top quality bear pelts on.
Best room. Let's see if he's selling any. Yay! I think I need two? Yeah. It does say that on the side. Oh, can we talk to this guy? He's still standing there. Darien, yeah.
We've got to build up our walls while there's still time.
Okay. Well, I'm gonna go fight eyeless things or whatever. My neighbor claims she saw one of those things, twice as tall as our gates. Yeah, they're big. Yay! I heard the cannons from here! Wengra must be enjoying herself. And our curtain wall is done. Ooh. Captain Ogner? Ung? A few town guards stand arrayed around a sprawled corpse. One of them turns as you approach, giving you a nod. You've got an uncanny sense of timing, Lady Theodess. This one here's been after you all day. That sounds familiar, Aloth says. He slowly turns his head to regard you. How can you be sure? The dark looks like you're getting from some of the locals, for sure. Hard to miss. Seems like they're not the only ones you've managed to tick off. Agne toes at the nearby corpse with a boot. This woman was going about town asking about your whereabouts. Not in a polite sort of way, either. She got nervous in a hurry when we happened by. Nearly took Roiland's head off. Mm-hmm. Never seen her before. Doubt you missed out on much there. I suggest having a look at what she was carrying. See if you recognize anything. Huh. The Phylactery's promise. In Stalwart, a violent scat was brought down by the town guards, but not before she was observed, demanding information as to my whereabouts. The assassin has been killed, but that's no deterrent to a watcher. Perhaps I can find some clue as to why this person was sent after me. Best keep an eye out. Guess we ought to get a shovel. A woman's cooling corpse lies half buried in the snow. The cause of death is clear, a narrow wound under her throat. The essence here is already faint and fading fast. Well, let's reach out, because her pockets are still going to be here. You plunge into a cold darkness, scattered images sliding past before you can grasp more than an echo, and then light. Sunlight filters down through gaps in the canopy, illuminating short stretches of the bog. Mud and knee-deep water foul each step. Your legs are already tired, and you've barely started. You must resign yourself to discomfort. You'll come to the river soon enough. Follow as it bends north. It is a mantra in your thoughts. Reach Stalwart. Find the watcher. Follow her. Retrieve the phylactery. The phylactery. Is she one of Consulhart's apprentices? Right. Consulhart's killer will not fall easily, but if you are careful, that task will not fall to you alone. Your master will deal with the Watcher. It is only a matter of time. The memory slips away, returning you to the familiar sight of Stalwart Village, perhaps stirred into flight by your perusal. The soul essence begins to dissipate, fading from your sight. I don't want to fight that guy again. The memory of the dead woman's journey lingers with you, however. To the southwest, beyond the White March, there lies a bog, and an enemy awaits you there. Really? Prior to Stalwart, the scout traveled through a bog on the edge of Ir Glanfath to the southwest of the White March. I expect I will find her employer thereabouts. Alright, so still picking up more quests. Oh, that's it. Now we can't search her pockets? That doesn't make any sense. Alright, I already looked through everything else. So what's this bog? Let me take a peek. I'm not going there, just gonna... Oh. Maroglick Fen? Or E-N? Okay. Northeast of Craghole Bluffs, okay. Interesting. We might just go there first. Okay. Yeah, we might just go there first. Check out that bog. Thanks for watching, guys. See you next time. You know? If this is timed, yeah, we probably will just... I probably will face the eyeless next time. Because I don't want to be going to the bog, and meanwhile they're coming around stomping around. From what everyone says, it has to be done soon. So if that's a hint that I have to do it next... Let's do it next. So yeah, next time. Eyeless powers somehow. Calling upon friends to aid. Cool. Thanks for watching. See you next time and endure. In enduring, grow strong.